What's going on, guys? Tom Bielko back, and welcome to another video. In this video, I will be showing you how to download the replay mod in Minecraft 1.16.4. Before we get into this video, I have a quick announcement. Memberships are now available on my channel. There are two levels. There's Epic Gamer and Legendary. Epic Gamer is $2.99, Legendary is $5.99. All you have to do is click the join button, and it will show you all of the details. Make sure to click that join button and check out all the details if you are interested. So the sites you will need are all in the description, but the first one I will show you is Minecraft Replay Mod. The Replay Mod site, as of the recording of this video, looks like this. Exactly like this, and you can download whichever one of these files. I'm pretty sure it will work. I know it will work with these first few, but the farther you go back, I don't know if this version of Fabric will work with it. But all you will need to do on this site is just click the download button. And since I'm using Chrome, it comes up down here on the downloads thing. But once you click download, it will go to wherever your browser has the downloads. Wherever, if you're using Safari, I think there's like an arrow in the corner or whatever. But the next site you will need to visit is FFmpeg. Where you need to go is you go to download. And then it takes you to a page that looks like this. Then, based off of your computer's operating system, you need to choose the correct files. Like, since I'm on Windows, I hover over this or click it or whatever, and then it brings up the Windows files. And then all you do is you click the top one, and then it redirects you to a page that looks like this. Then you scroll down to the links. I'm pretty sure this is similar for the other editions, but you scroll down to the links, you ignore these two links, and you ignore these, and the only one you need to concern yourself with is Mirror. You click the mirror links and it brings up a set of files. The only file that you need to download is the ffmpeg.zip file. The second one that you see right here is the only one you'll need to download. I have already downloaded this right here, so I do not need to download it, but all you have to do is click it and it comes wherever your downloads go. The next site is Fabric, fabricmc.net. It is in the description. This one is the mod loader that loads the replay mod. And since it is a mod loader, you can use Optifine too. So I will link this in the description too. This is just the home. You can go to downloads, show all versions, and then download this one right here, 1.16.4. So for the Fabric site, it doesn't really matter which one of these I use because I'm on Windows. But if you are on Windows, I guarantee you should use the windows.exe. It will be the easiest option. But if you're on another site, you can download the .jar and it will look just like this replaymod.jar I have up here. The very next thing you need to do is navigate to your Minecraft launcher. And you go to Java Edition and you make sure that you have loaded the most recent edition of Minecraft. Or whichever edition you picked for the Fabric loader, you need to load that version to make sure that all of the files are downloaded and all of the files are there for Fabric to load. I'm going to download Fabric. So what you do is you just double click it and then it loads and pops up with this little window thing right here. You can choose the edition. So if you wanted to use Optifine 1.16.5, you can. See, I have Fabric for 1.16.4. So I am going to update the edition right here. So all you have to do is just this folder just run is already correct. You do not need to change this. Whenever you download this, these will be the most recent versions of Minecraft and of the Fabric loader. So you don't need to change anything at all. All you need to do is click the install button. Basically, no time at all. As you see, it just barely popped up. And it notifies me that 1.16.5 Fabric Loader was installed. And all you need to do is click on the .minecraft folder. You do not need to do anything else. I have it already installed, so I don't need to do this, but you need to make a folder called mods if there's not already one there. So I will enter the mods folder, and as you can see, I have a bunch of different files here. But since I don't need these anymore, all you need to do is drag your replay mod file into the mods section. And that's it. You don't need to do anything else. You just need to drag the .jar of this in there. The only one you need to install if it's a .jar is the Fabric. You need to have Fabric installed in order for this to actually run. I have cleared out the folder, and now if you want to download Optifine, here's what you do. You take your Optifine.jar, drag it in there, and if you actually want Optifine to run on the Fabric mod loader, you will need to download the Optifabric.jar. And that is downloaded by going to this link right here. All you'll need to do is go to this site right here, and you click Files, and then just click Download right there. And once you have the file, just drag it into the folder, and you should be good to go. Once you have thrown those files into that .minecraft folder, you will need to install FFmpeg. FFmpeg is an essential part to run and save your replays from the replay mod. What you will need to do is copy this folder. You can right-click it and click copy. And then you go to this PC, and then whichever one has your Windows on it, which mine is local disk C, and you go to program files x86. And right here is where you will need to paste that folder, and it will ask for administrator permission, and you will click continue, and it will copy over everything in that folder just like that. And the next thing that you will need to do is rename it, because a lot of the times it will not let you actually use FFmpeg unless you rename it. So what you need to do is you need to delete everything at the end and just leave FFmpeg. And you save it just like that. That is all you need to do for this. Once you moved the FFmpeg folder into the x86 file folder, you need to open it. And then you open the bin folder. And then right here, there is FFmpeg.exe. You right-click it, and then you go down here to Properties, and you make sure that you copy this right here, the file location. You right-click it and click Copy. Then, once you have dragged all the folders in, all the .jar folders, have Fabric installed, and then have FFmpeg in the correct folder, just like I showed you, all you need to do is make sure you are navigated to the correct Fabric loader, correct edition. Its Fabric loader should look like this, and you click play just like that. Once you have opened the Fabric loader that you just installed, right here you can see Replay Viewer. And all you need to do is click it, and once you have a replay recorded, you can click on that replay, and then you click load to load into the replay that you have made. And as you can see, I have already done a little bit of editing right here so that it has something to render. So all you need to do is click Render Camera Path and then scroll to the bottom. Once you've scrolled down to the bottom, all you need to do is paste the path that you have just copied. You click Control V and it pastes it right in there, just like that. All you need to do is copy it in there using whatever Command V, whatever this computer uses. And then you type /ffmpeg.exe and then you click Render, and then it opens the rendering page and properly renders the video. Once the render has completed, all you need to do is push the open video folder and it will open the folder that has your finished render in it. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like and smash that subscribe button. See you in another video.